How you guys doing? So yeah, man. So on this video here, what I'll be doing for you guys is I'll be showing you how to make the melody for AKA's new song or one of his latest songs, which is Dreamwork. It's actually been out for some time now, where it's featuring Yanga on the song. So I'll show you how to make the melody for that song, the instruments I use, the keys, everything else, and then yeah. So let's go straight to it. Let me know if you want the FOP. So let me just try play this for you first, and then I'll explain everything afterwards. So it sounds like this. So I'm just gonna cut it off there before my PC messes up. But that's pretty much the gist of the melody. So to explain this part first before I go to the instruments, you've got this pattern and this pattern. The only difference between the two is this key here. It's this little thing here. So you see on pattern one you got one, and then you got that one there. On the second pattern you got one, two, and that one there. So it goes one, two, three. It's the same thing. I'll show you when I show you the actual layout of the keys. And then what I did here is I just decreased the volume of this pattern. I just took it down. I just took it down there. Both this, the different instruments that make up this pattern here, I decreased the volume because that's what actually happens on the original song. When this one comes in, this one tends to go a bit down in the volume. So it's all part of the mixing process, but I just figured let me do it as well so that it sounds and feels realistic to you guys. And then yeah, pattern one, let's go to pattern one. So this is the difference. Let's look at it from this purity plugin. You see this is pattern one. This key is missing. E5 is not there. Where's pattern two? You've got E5. You see that's the difference. Not there, there, not there, there. That's the difference. Basically pattern one is how the melody actually starts. It starts off with D5, then straight to F5 like that. And then after that, it just keeps on going. Like in a sequence like this, it keeps on repeating itself, so it's sort of like a loop, you know. So that's how it basically starts. And then pattern three is your second part of the melody, which is the still drum, which is this part here. You understand? So for that, these are the keys for that. Let me show you the keys for pattern one as well, so you can see them. These are the keys for the first part of the melody, which is this one here. You see, and then the difference between pattern one and pattern two is that pattern two is like. You get it? That's the only difference, really. So it's just like a loop of pattern one without that gap there. And then these are the keys, screen grab, do whatever you want to do. And in terms of the FOP, I'm not too sure if I'm going to share the FOP yet. Yeah, so I'll think about it. So, but there's no need to share the FOP. I mean, you can just write the keys down and then repeat it yourself. But and then put the tempo BPM on 86 and just do this yourself. I'll show you everything. I'll pretty much explain everything for you guys. So let's see. So I've explained, I've showed you guys the keys for the first part of the pattern. Of the melody, let me show you, and I've showed you guys the keys for this melody here, the second part of the melody. And then let me go into the instruments then. So the instruments you have, I use the muted guitar for this part here, for this sound, so it sounds like this on its own. You hear it. So all I did to it, I just muted guitar. It's here, it's under GM normal, muted guitar there. And then all I did was add a bit of reverb to it, you know, not too much. So I cut down the level, not too much. You just need a bit of it, and then you sort of what is this? I think this is the attack, nah? Yeah, this is the attack. So you sort of like just push it a bit forward so that it doesn't start exactly on the thing. Just go boom, sort of like boom, you know. I don't know, but the point is. Just move this thing to the right a bit. This is the attack. from my understanding. So you want to move that to the right, just as much as I did there, not too much, you know. Yeah, I'm lazy to change it because then I might not get it exactly right. But let me just do it. Let me play for you guys. Like, yeah. Now let me move it. You hear the difference? So now you can hear the difference. So let me just put it back there. I think it's about 0.09. So it's about 0.009 seconds. And then, yeah, so that's pretty much that. That's what I did with the muted guitar. And then I went to... Then I pretty much opened up another Purity plugin, which is this one, Purity number 2. And then I added what you call echo drops, which is also on the GM normal. Then you just select echo drops. Anything special on it? Nah, everything is as is. So once you open Purity and you select echo drops, everything that's here is exactly how it's going to pop up. And then all I did was... Nah, I didn't do anything actually. I just kept it the same. So that's all you want to do. And then balancing of volumes, obviously, I mean, you want to balance out your volume. So this is slightly louder, and this is generally a loud sound. The echo drops are generally loud. It sounds like this. You understand? So you want to take down the volume for it a bit, which is what I did there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And then pattern number 3, which is your these sounds here. This one's quite tricky. It's got a lot of sounds that I used, and the reason I use all these sounds is obviously because I'm trying to get it to sound as similar as it is to the original track. So what I did is I opened up another Purity plugin again. So I pretty much made the whole melody from just one plugin, and then steel drum, kalimba, and echo drops, they're all under the same thing. They're all under GM normal. There you can see steel drum, kalimba is somewhere around here, and echo drops is somewhere around there. So you can see it's all the same, you know, same category, it doesn't change. And then all I did was with the steel drum, I opened it up, everything stays the same. You don't change anything to it, you don't add anything. Oh yeah, sorry, you actually do add a bit of reverb to it, add some reverb to it, and then delay. But you don't need the delay, but you can add it. I just added it and then I changed the time. It just sounds better like that. And then you need to take this up to 12, plus 12. It's going to go in 0 like this. You just come and click and then you put it on plus 12 like that. That's basically the octave. It just increases the octave for this specific sound, excuse me. Kalimba, you just add it, nothing changes. Echo drops, you just add it and you cut down the volume there. I told you echo drops is generally a loud sound. So the reason why I'm cutting down the volume here instead of here or there this time around is because I put in all these different sounds. So if I cut it down here, it's going to cut down the volume for all the sounds. So I don't want to cut down the volume of these two sounds. I just want to cut down the volume of this specific sound. That's why I took the volume down from here instead of there or there or there. So that's pretty much it. So I'll play the whole thing again for you guys, and then yeah man, hope you guys like this. Let me know if you think something is wrong with it. I've got a feeling something is wrong with my first key, especially on this part here. I think something is wrong. I'm not too sure if this is the right key, but anyway, it sounds good for now. It does the job. So yeah, so let me just play it one more time for you guys, and then yeah. So that's pretty much how that sounds, man. Yeah, in terms of the FOP, I haven't decided if I'm going to share it yet or not. So yeah, you guys let me know in the comment section if you want it. And yeah, increase those subscribe numbers as well. Those subscribers, and the more subscribers, the more likely I am to share all these things, you know. So yeah, so you make sure you subscribe. Other than that, man, like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow. All that just there. Do check out my other videos. I do have other tutorials with where I remake other melodies and beats and stuff like that. I try and cover both hip hop melodies and some house beats. So yeah, planning on buying a camera soon. I'm gonna be buying a camera soon, and I'm gonna be doing like live videos for you guys, where I teach you guys more stuff that you can't see on the screen, which might help you out. And I'm introducing some new features to the channel. A whole lot of things, I'm gonna start as soon as the thing, as soon as I get the camera in about 2 weeks' time. So yeah, the channel is gonna be, it's going to get very interesting, let me just put it that way. Otherwise, yeah man, like, subscribe, comment, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, follow, all that jazz there. Sharp, sharp, Buffett.